It's my home. It's my heart. It's just heartbreaking.
Some people on Pine Island have been living in the dark after the hurricane made landfall 2 weeks ago.
NBC2's Claire Lavazzorio is live on the island to show you the work to restore the power.
There is devastation everywhere you look on Pine Island. Take a look at this. This used to be someone's home. There's a lawnmower sitting untouched in the front yard and this basketball here. But through this devastation, hundreds of linemen, and they're at work right now. Take a look down the street. They are here hard at work trying to bring some sense of normalcy to the people who still live here. Hope is traveling on wheels.
It's my home. It's my heart. It's just heartbreaking.
And coming in droves for the people of Pine Island.
I'm very surprised. I never thought this would be this fast.
Today, nearly 600 Duke Energy crews are the first to welcome you to the island. They're busy rebuilding entire power poles Ian knocked over like toothpicks. For the first time in 2 weeks, some are no longer living in darkness. Marlou Besoms is one of the lucky ones.
I went home and sure enough, I have power. I'm very surprised. I never thought this would be this fast. I thought it was going to be months.
Others like Rhonda Zarnicki are still patiently waiting.
This is beyond your wildest imagination. There is absolutely no comparison.
Even though it's been a long 2 weeks, Zarnicki says she's grateful to have a home that's able to reconnect to power when many do not.
I'm a positive person. You know, I always believe that everything, you know, happens for a reason, and I always look for the positive in everything. So I'm okay.
LCEC's latest power outage map shows more than 7,000 customers are still waiting for their lights to turn back on today. But again, this neighborhood just north of Pine Island Center could have their electricity restored as soon as tonight. I'm live on Pine Island, Claire Lavazzorio, NBC2.